Good afternoon, friends, and welcome to Watercolor Painting in the Afternoon. Today, I am painting in my Hahanemuehle sketchbook. I've got a drawing here. There's the horizon line. You know, various parts of the drawing are showing in the background. A little bit of water in the foreground, and then a field of purple flowers. So, I wanted to give this sketchbook a fair trial. To be honest with you, I was not 100% pleased with how the sketchbook handles paint. The paper is a little bit thin, and so I wasn't just thrilled with it. But, you know, it's all right. And I'm going to use it up anyway. I've been painting landscapes in it. So, that is what I'm painting today as well. The sky first. I think this is a cobalt blue. This is one of the problems that I have with this paper, is that it does not paint a wash very well. It's streaky when you're finished with it, and it just doesn't, you know, it just doesn't blend all that well. But I don't have anything that's Hahanemuehle. It's just not quite as good as the Strathmore book I used to use. But anyway, that has to dry. And then we'll get the, before I put the rest of the background in, and then we'll get the water. The water, I put a little bit of red in with the blue to make it look maybe kind of purpley instead of just the blue of the sky. I wanted it to be slightly different, and it was different in the photograph as well. So, added just a little tiny bit, I think it was alizarin crimson, to the cobalt blue. At this point, I really did have to let it dry before I could move on to the next part. And I sped it up a little bit here because it was taking quite a long time to record. But this is the grasses in the foreground. One thing you have to remember about green is that you need more than one shade of green. You need, really, the way I've been doing it lately has been three shades. A light green, a medium green, and a dark green. Three or more. Because otherwise you just lack any kind of depth in your painting. So yeah, I've been trying to do that more. Here, I'm going to start on the trees. Sorry, that was my phone just squeaking. What a sound. That's what it sounds like when you speed up the thing. Some more yellowish grasses in the foreground of the foreground of the background, and then I'm just putting in some strokes that make it look like has a grassy texture. I really didn't know how to do this. I wanted to put the flowers, I wanted to make the flowers really pop out in the front. And along with the foliage. And I'm not sure that I accomplished exactly what I wanted, but this was the best that I knew how to do it. And we have just dotting in these purple flowers. And then I used some negative painting to put the foliage on the background. A few stems. Some white space for the highlights. I decided to use a larger brush because that was just going too slowly. Oh no, actually I was painting the branch next. Okay. So that was a really dark brown that I was making with burnt umber and ivory black. I'm letting, I imagine what I was thinking was letting the background green there dry before I started putting on the others. Now here I am going ahead and getting the rest of the leaves painted in, leaving the negative spaces so that it looks like some leaves are highlighted on the side and some are more in the shade. I can't tell you exactly whether or not this worked out perfectly for me, but I wanted to try it and I wanted to see what this method would do. It worked out alright. I think I got the right look in the end. It took a long time to do these leaves. Trying to paint around the highlights. I would love to hear how other people do small highlights in a dense undergrowth like that. If you would comment, let me know how you do that. I would really appreciate that. I'd love to know how other people tackle that kind of very complex looking image. I also learned that if the purple flowers have about the same value as the green, then you have a tendency to be able to see them as well. So when painting your own scenes, if you've got flowers and greenery that are about the same value, meaning they're about as, one is about as dark as the other, but they're different colors, it's going to be hard to distinguish. It's going to be hard to see them. But, you can put a very dark color around a lighter color, and it'll really stand out. So I think that that was something I learned from this, too, is that I was going to have to alter the color of the flowers if I wanted them to stand out. Now, here I'm going to go back and put the shadow in the distant trees. You can see how one note the green is if you don't do that. So the final bit here, I'm pretty sure that when this was all finished, I let it dry, came back the next day, and I added even more dark color, even more dark green with the grasses and some of the leaves in the foreground, because I just think once it dries, it's going to be so much lighter than what it looks like here, and it's hard to get it too dark. So you work on that a little bit. That's something that I've always had to really work with. Here I'm going to just dry brush a few the idea of the leaves into these branches, and then go back and fill it in with some more distinct leaves. I can remember to do so. I'll show you a picture of the final result, because I did go back and add a few deeper greens after the fact. I'll try to remember to take a photo so that you can see what I did the next morning. Always a good idea to go back the next morning and take one last look at what you've done, and then you can say, it needs this or it needs that. I think it turned out fairly well.